Hello everyone, my name is Mudan Chen, one of CDG 18. I'm supervised by Professor Stephen Hollett, Dr. Bing Zhang, Giuliano Allegri, and Sven Friedman. So my topic for share today is the effects of ferromagnetic and carbon fiber zippings on the magnetic properties of composites. And zippening is a traditional thickness reinforcement technology. But however, in recent years, there is an increasing demand on the multifunctionalities of composites. And here are two examples of the application of zippening. So the first one is the mode 1 and 2 delamination bridging monitoring. And another one is the heat flow transfer. But the fiber reinforced polymer composites are magnetic inert, which lead to an important limitation. That a lot of research has been conducted to produce magnetic composites. Below is an example to use the magnetic field to actuate the trailing edge. It was realized by filling the fluid inside of a hollow glass fibers. So our research for the first time explores the feasibilities of enhancing the magnetic property of composites by zippening. The IM7 prepreg has been used with a QI stacking sequence, and the 2P materials has been investigated at three different volume fractions. Below is the configuration of the 2% ZPN sample. The squid MPMS-3 located in the physics department has been used for this measurement because it can measure the flux, the magnetic flux inside of the sample directly. On the right are the sample installations. The top are for the single pins and the bottom are for the Z-pin samples. So next is the experimental result of the unpinned and the carbon fiber pinned samples. And from the MH curves, we can see that they have a decreased linear shape. That means they are both magnetic. And by looking at the magnetic susceptibilities listed in the legend, which is the slope of the curves, we can see that the carbon fibers values are quite close to unpinned sample. So that means the carbon fiber pins have no large influence. While when we look at the nickel iron Z-pin sample, we can see that the MH curves are totally different. They reveal the very soft ferromagnetic behavior due to the permalloy pin. And the laminate has become strongly paramagnetic due to the pins. And also the linear part susceptibility has been increased up to 1.87 for the autoplane direction and 0.13 for the in-plane. So next, we want to see the influence of the nickel iron pin volume fraction on the global behavior. So we plotted the testing data versus the against the rule of mixture. We can see that. So it's quite interesting to find that for the autoplane direction, it's a nonlinear behavior, while for the in-plane, it's linear. In order to explain this experimental phenomenon, so we have used the FEA tool, Composites, to help us understand this. And this is the sample configuration. And here is the comparison of modeling data versus raw mixture. And we can see that the same trend has been found with the experiment. So then next, we took the slice of the cross-section of the sample and plotted the magnetic flux and their density. So it shows that under a certain magnetic field, and the flux density inside of the pins decreases with the pin numbers. That means there is the interactions between adjacent pins. And while for the implant direction, the flux density inside of the pins are almost the same. That means there is no interaction. So in summary, it's feasible to tailor the magnetic properties of composites by choosing pin materials, control the volume fraction and the laminate thickness. So that's all, thank you. And if you want more information, please feel free to the recently published paper in Composite Science and Technology. Yeah, thank you. Yeah.